What's up guys, welcome back for another Yu-Gi-Oh! Pro Duel video. Next match, Crossbalanced Cup, a big one here in the top 16 playoffs, all the way on the top indeed. We have Invoked Dragon or Invoked Dragoon versus 2019 Pure Thunder Dragons, that is. This is a Thunder Dragon decklist, as you know, pretty much the same as like always, right? It's paired up against definitely one of the title candidates being the Invoked Dragoon deck from Master Rule 4, right at the end of Master Rule 4, like February, I believe, January, February. From the OCG, again, Dragon, Dragoon. So which deck has the advantage? An interesting one, seeing from the votes from the people from the previous video, is it Invoked Dragon or Invoked Dragoon? 70%, that's a lot. I know why, from the comments, you know, the hand traps are definitely in favor, I guess, of Invoked, or at least from the OCG build, because they have access to triple Maxi. As you see here, Maxi gaining, well, this is especially a nice one for one. And again, yeah, indeed, if Colossus hits the board, then that Maxi definitely paid off for the sweet plus one. Super Poly is indeed main deck here in the build, because again, I mean, the opposing fields back then, part of a popular main deck, if not side deck choice, right? And that is the thing with this particular deck list. It's running, I believe, two Super Poly in the main deck and, you know, gazillion amount of hand traps, like Double Blossom. I believe Triple Effect Failure also, next to obviously the Triple Maxi and Triple Impermanence. The standard opening that this deck can pump out is, of course, the Anaconda Makaba, and eventually, you know, using Anaconda's effect of going for Dragoon. And I believe, is this, yeah, this should be exactly 8k, because that's why I tried to indeed, yeah, negate the Ghost Ogre, right? And double Alistair, yeah, okay, that's indeed exactly 8k. This is the downside opening with Dark Magician, or at least one of your bricks, and I'm going first, so I was like, that's a bummer. I mean, I think I side-ticked some extra going second cards. Nibiru, I believe, was one of them. But anyway, so drop Carabine, obviously, normal summon the Alistair, trying to get a search. Call by the Grave definitely helps a lot. This is one of the reasons why Call by the Grave currently is at 1 in a TCG and 2 in the OCG, but still, 2 is still okay, but 1 is just, you know, it doesn't really help out too much. Anyway, so I'm going for my standard opening board, you know, double negation, Dragoon and Makaba, but that's it, right? I mean, the two cards in my hand are just going to be discard fodder, but the going second hand, I guess, for Thunder Dragon wasn't that great. I believe drawing into another copy of the regular Thunder Dragon and double mind control, ugh, that truly is not going to help. So next duel, again, he's letting me start, so again, I'm going first, and again, I'm opening with Dark Magician. The Call by the Grave is there again, but, you know, no follow-up play this time. With that, I mean an extender of going for Anaconda. So get off Makaba, and, well, this is like two interruptions. Well, you have the Makaba, not really sure what my set is. Is it like Impermanence? Not really sure. So Colossus hits the board, Titan as well, okay, that's cool. So that's definitely a threat. I think the Dark is going to get indeed negated by the Ash Blossom, that's cool. Ah, Call by the Grave, okay, Call by the Grave indeed negating the Dark, preventing the search, right? The Fusion is, no, obviously I want to negate it, but the Ghost Ogre is indeed going to pop or get rid of the Makaba, and that blows me away, sets me back by a lot. You know, like a top deck as Alistair, I guess, or a field spell would definitely help out, but it's not the case, and I believe Thunder is going to OTK here. So again, Colossus, that's a thing, right, with old school Thunder Dragon, the fact that they can pump out multiple Colossus. This is Master Rule 4, by the way, Master Rule 4 versus Master Rule 4. So again, Thunder is, you know, forced to, I guess, go for the Link Summon first, but some summoner can turn itself into Big Boy Colossus. So I want to go second, and I see my opening hand, and I was like, this could be good, or this could be terrible because of the Nibiru, and obviously, yeah, only I think like one or two summons. So immediately go for the Red Eyes Fusion, since again, that freaking Dark Magician always in the opening hand. Mind Control I left in, you know, Colossus. It's basically a second monster for the Anaconda play if I have like Alistair or whatever. Yeah, double Call by is not going to help against Imperial Order. That's Thunder Dragon. They're sitting on their Floodgate beatstick being Colossus, and obviously they'll draw into the other Floodgates, like again Imperial Order, Macrocosmos maybe. Even though I don't think this Thunder build is running too many Floodgates. Yeah, what can I do? So 2-2, who would have thought that? And okay, I definitely want to go second. I mean, double Nibiru, I think, triple Maxi, double Blossom, triple Impermanence, double Super Poly. I definitely want to go second. And Ash Blossom is dropped on the Aloof Loop, and well, eventually on the Dark, I guess. Not really sure which one was Chainlink number one. Called by the Grave, indeed, Hugh again comes in really clutch, because that lets me search the Carabine, and, you know, Carabine into Anaconda, into Dragoon, definitely simplifies the game state by a lot. But I let the effect go through, so Thunders again getting back a potential Petri Man, and maybe like a Light in the Graveyard. But seeing that I have like, double Interruption, well, triple maybe, because Super Poly, the Hand Trap being Ash Blossom and Dragoon, I keep one card in hand because, you know, the discard of Dragoon and the Super Poly as well. And this is, of course, a huge, huge blowout, dropping the Super Polymerization here on, I believe, double Dark? Yeah, should be double Dark because Venom hits the field. I believe the fusion is going to get negated by Dragoon, and this is indeed more than enough to a deck for a game. So, I feel this was an okay matchup, but it seems that again the big anti floodgates or hand trap cards, well, I mean, Super Poly definitely came in clutch in this particular matchup, but that's why the card, you know, was played back then, either main or side deck. Anyway, so, okay, Thunders will still move on the left side of the bracket, the loser's bracket, that they'll take on Master Rule 4 Heroes. And, again, Dragoon will take on Astrograph, Pendulum, Electromite, Shenanigans. Okay, good one. Next matchup, we have Plantlings, aka 2018 Good Stuff Link from the OCG. It's going to take on another force here in the Crossbalanced Cup, and that's Madolchis from 2020. So feel free to leave your prediction. Okay, guys, that's it. Thanks for watching. Feel free to click or like if you enjoyed the video. Leakum signing out. Peace.